first of our reports.
There were 25 local marches in Dublin. Hundreds turned out in Dunamead on the northern outskirts. Others set out from Ringsend near the city centre, joining other groups to march on the Dáil. From Phibsborough, the marchers proceeded directly to O'Connell Street to meet protesters from all over the city.
I don't agree with the water charges at all. I think it's a human right, basic human right.
Because we're not paying for water, Irish water that we paid for already.
I mean, I'm paying house tax now, bin taxes and all. Where does it end? On €193 a week.
Hard-won rights from over hundreds of years from the labour movement, from workers and working people are being eroded by austerity across Europe.
The local marches were organised by the Right to Water group, who said they're a message for the government.
Irish water will be free!
We're not looking for any sort of tax credits, or we're not looking for, you know, more allowances or anything else. The message is very clear. We want to get rid of water charges and we want to get rid of Irish water.
The O'Connell Street rally was organised by the Dublin Says No group, who have also vowed to continue the campaign.
You only have to look here today and on the 11th of October and on the next marches, there's going to be bigger and better than what it is, and it's going to carry on, and we're not going to stop until these water charges are abolished.
The government says it is willing to offer concessions, but says that the charges are here to stay. Further protests are now being planned for December 10th.
The first of six protests in the county got underway in Bandon at midday, and despite the torrential rain, some 400 determined protesters armed with umbrellas made their way through the town to hand in a petition at the offices of local Fine Gael TD Jim Daly.
This is not about a political group, and I don't care what politicians are here. This is about water and citizens are being wronged.
I think it's the end of the line, really. It's the last straw. We're entitled to drink water. We're entitled to shower.
I'm concerned that it's going to be a privatised company, and then that means they'll have a monopoly and they'll be able to charge what they want.
Then they travel from Bandon and outlying towns such as Cove and Middleton and villages like Ballyhay in North Cork to join marchers in the city centre for the second anti-water charges march in a week. But the numbers were much bigger, 2,000 last weekend to some 10,000 and upwards today.
I think it's the final straw that broke the camel's back. I think we have to protest today just to show the government no more.
Because we feel it is unfair what they're doing, it is unjust, you know. Like, I mean, the thing is, if they put anything on it, they'll drive it up every year and there'll be no stop to it, you know. They'll use it as a budget gimmick.
No problem with water preservation, but why don't they fund Irish Waters from the money they're already collecting from us instead of trying to get us to pay a second time?
This gives us control, this gives us power. It's a great feeling that the numbers here today are so huge.
An estimated 5,000 people marched from a number of suburbs to Limerick city centre as part of the national demonstration against water charges. This was the second Saturday in a row where thousands of people in Limerick city took to the streets in a strong show of resistance to the charges. They were urged to get active in their neighbourhoods and to continue to resist the charges and the installation of water meters as part of what march leaders called a community-wide revolt against water charges.
This is the straw that's broke the camel's back for me. This government is a joke. They think the people are just going to lie down and take every tax that comes at them, and it's just not fair.
I came out to support the cause. It's we're not paying for water. It's falling from the skies.
I think we're paying enough, and we're just strapped, and you just can't do it anymore. And now look at it. Look at all the rain that's coming down today. No way.
A similar message on the streets of Galway as a further 3,000 people marched from the city's Spanish Arch to Eyre Square, chanting, "We won't pay," the slogan heard across the country today.
We pay already. This is an added extra charge that is unnecessary.
I'm just sick of the government throwing out all these charges, and I wouldn't mind if they fixed our water system first before this charge came about, but no, they've just decided to tax us. As an Irish person, I'm not happy.
Organisers say further marches are planned for the end of November and again in December.
Donegal said no again today in huge numbers. Well over 10,000 people took to the streets in three separate protests. The biggest crowd, estimated in the region of 8,000 people, made their feelings known in Letterkenny. Up to 4,000 marched through Ballyshannon, while a smaller crowd turned out in Lifford. People power was the chant from the crowd marching through Sligo, a crowd which grew street by street as more people joined in, eventually swelling the protest march to about 4,000 people.
It's an absolute disgrace in this time of austerity and all what the Irish people have gone through, losing their homes. What can we afford to do now? Nothing.
Too many taxes now. Too many. We're paying enough with a universal social charge. Surely water is a universal right. Take the money out of the universal social charge.
In County Leitrim, the feelings were equally strong among the 1,000 or so protesters who marched through Carrick and Shannon.
This is a wake-up call from us. If you want to be in government next year, get rid of the water rates.
People are just fed up with the way that things have gone on. It's give and give and give, and we just don't have any more to give. That's it.
Eileen Magner, RTE News, Carrick and Shannon.
Despite grey skies and heavy rain, more than 5,000 protesters took to the streets of Waterford City, expressing anger and frustration at a charge many feel is unjust.
We won't pay. We are pushed to the limits as it is.
In County Louth, similar numbers demonstrated in Dundalk. And in one of the largest protests outside Dublin and Cork, up to 8,000 people gathered in Drogheda. While smaller crowds marched through towns like Carrigonshire, County Tipperary and Goree in County Wexford, the message for the government was just as strong.
We're rising up and saying enough is enough. You bailed out the banks and we're suffering.
Criticism too on the streets of Cavan, where more than 3,000 people demonstrated.
This is not just about Irish water. This is about the future of this country.
The bankers are back banking, the builders are back building, and we have the burden of the water charges.
Playing the same tune in Portlaw, County Waterford, hometown of Paddy Coffey, Minister for State at the Department of the Environment. With thousands more saying no to water charges in towns and villages across the country, demonstrators say they've sent a clear signal of discontent to the coalition parties. Sharon Gaffney, RTE News.